फ्लो स्टेटमेंट शुड बी मेड बाय द कॉर्पोरेट एज पर अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड 3 देयर दे हैव गिवन द पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मेट एंड एनी ऑफ द कंपनीज एनुअल रिपोर्ट यू विल फाइंड अलोंग विद द एनुअल रिपोर्ट देयर इज ऑलवेज कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट बिकॉज कैश फ्लो स्टेटमेंट और रादर कैश फ्लो इज वेरी वेरी इंटीग्रल सब्सटेंस फॉर ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर बिकॉज इफ एनी मैनिपुलेशन इज फिजिबल एंड पॉसिबल इट इज थ्रू कैश सो it is mandatory for us that for all the stakeholders including the shareholders being the corporate we need to give the entire justification for inflow and outflow of cash so as per AS3 cash has been subdivided inflow and outflow of cash has been subdivided in three categories that is operating activity investing activity and financing activity So operating activity basically what we do in normal course of business from where whatever the net cash flow we generated is known as cash flow from operating activity and then in investment activity we incorporate all kind of selling of asset or buying of asset selling of investment or buying of investment so whenever there is a sale of investment there will be inflow of cash whenever there is a buy of asset or investment there will be outflow of cash accordingly you will get the net cash flow from investing activity finally financing activity through financial instruments I mean shares debentures bond loans etc so again if you it is just reverse than investing activity when you issue the shares there will be inflow of cash and when you will redeem the shares or buy back the shares or repay the loan there will be outflow of cash so with that concept we did few questions and I have asked you to do one homework also how many of you have done it am I audible to you all let me ask that meri awaaz aap tak aa rahi hai
yes sir
maine kuch poocha मैं आपको रिमाइंड कराता हूँ ये क्वेश्चन मैंने दिया था आपको एज अ होमवर्क याद आ रहा है नहीं किया रहेगा एज यूजुअल ठीक है बट I told you next week I am going to check this both units along with the VIPA. So your second continuous evaluation will be after the break because Friday there is a holiday Saturday and then Monday I am going to check your unit one, unit two. Today I am going to finish entire unit. So again I am reminding this will include basics of financial management, needs of financial management, the basic. Theoretical aspect, then ratio analysis, then cash flow statement analysis, and capital budgeting, which is the syllabus for your CE1. So I want that everyone should be duly prepared, and all of you should get 20 out of 20 marks. So now let us read once again. This is 12% preference share capital 0 to 90,000. What it implies? Because in 2013 there was nothing. In 2014, 90,000 rupees. What it implies? इसका मतलब क्या है? Tell me. Any of you can give me the answer. What it implies? ये पर्टिकुलर आइटम को रीड करके आपको क्या समझ में आ रहा है
नेट कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंशियल एक्टिविटी
यस सो व्हाट इट इंप्लाइज देयर इज अ इशू ऑफ शेयर्स एंड देयर इज अ इनफ्लो इन फाइनेंशियल एक्टिविटी थैंक यू वेरी मच जीनरी सिमिलरली इफ यू गो टू इक्विटी शेयर कैपिटल व्हाट इट इंप्लाइज
Issue of shares.
Issue of shares. Absolutely right answer. Thank you, Jay. See, basically you have to be in this format only. इससे बाहर कुछ नहीं जाना है. या तो ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, या तो इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, या तो फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी. इसी में आपने आंसर देनी है. It's very important for you to read also. General Reserve. What it implies. क्या मतलब है इसका? See the format, you will be in a position to get me the answer. Format देखिए आप आंसर बता सकते हैं. What it implies here? It implies transfer the amount to general reserve, non-cash operating activity here. Yes or no? Hi, Anna.
Yes, sir.
Next.
Yes, sir.
Profit and loss. Profit and loss. Yes, operating activity. The very first item will start with the closing balance, and we will deduct the opening balance. Very correct. Thank you. 15% debenture.
Issue of
debenture. Because 1,08,000 से 1,17,000 हुआ, ठीक है. Creditors, sundry creditors. What it implying? क्या बता रहा है?
Changing in working capital.
I'm sorry for the technical glitches. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this creditor is declining. So क्या करेंगे आप changes in working capital में? Add करेंगे या subtract करेंगे?
Sir, add.
गलत जवाब. Credit when it is current liability, it is going as it is. If there is a decrease in current liability,
subtract. Yeah, it is subtract.
Less. If there is a decrease in current liability, we'll have to less. Yes, we have to subtract. Bank overdraft. Bank overdraft.
Cash flow from financial activity.
You can take, but here alternatively you can take as a current liability also. ये सारे आइटम बस करंट लायबिलिटी मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग में करंट के आइटम्स है. ओके, दैट इज आल्सो राइट, नो प्रॉब्लम. बट बैंक ओवरड्राफ्ट आपने देखा रहेगा, रेशियो में भी हमने इसको करंट लायबिलिटी लिया था. यस और नो?
यस सर.
बट इफ यू कंसीडर इट करंट लायबिलिटी देन व्हाट विल बी इफेक्ट?
यस सर.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Why? Because it is decreasing. Very good. Provision for tax. Provision for tax.
Cash flow from operating activities.
Well, if there is an adjustment, you can do that. Otherwise, the simpler way to consider these all as a current liability. So, current liability mein kya ho raha hai? It is increasing.
Add
karenge. Proposed dividend.
Net cash flow from financial activity.
वो भी कर सकते हो. Alternatively, मैं तो current liability में रखूंगा. Because see, that will make my life simpler. अगर मैं ये सबको current liability और current asset में रखता हूँ, तो things are very easy. Why? Because there is no adjustment. इन सबसे related कोई adjustment नहीं है. एक क्वेश्चन में था एडजस्टमेंट फैक्टर, वी डिड लॉट ऑफ होमवर्क ओवर देयर। अल्टरनेटिवली अगर हमने करंट लायबिलिटी में लिया तो भी काम राइट ही आंसर आएगा, ठीक है। अगेन इट इज इंक्रीजिंग, तो करंट लायबिलिटी इंक्रीजिंग, क्या करेंगे, ऐड करेंगे या सब्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे?
ऐड,
ठीक है। एक लॉजिक मैंने आपको इसके पहले एक क्वेश्चन कराया था, उसमें भी बताया था, लास्ट ईयर का प्रपोज डिविडेंड टू बी पेड दिस ईयर आउटफ्लो में आएगा, और करंट ईयर का प्रपोज डिविडेंड विल कम इन नॉन रिकरिंग आइटम, तो वैसे भी आप लिख सकते हैं। वैसा मैंने ऑलरेडी एक क्वेश्चन कराया है, बट दिस क्वेश्चन आई एम टेकिंग दिस इन अ डिफरेंट वे, ओके। अ फिक्स्ड असेट, देयर आर टू ऑप्शंस, यू कैन टेक सेपरेटली एंड प्रोविजन, बट दोनों का अगर नेट इफेक्ट दिया हुआ है तो वी विल गो फॉर द नेट इफेक्ट ओनली, सो दैट आई नीड नॉट हैव टू टेक इट सेपरेटली, डायरेक्ट हम फिक्स्ड असेट WDV पे ले लेंगे। क्या इंप्लाइज कर रहा है फिक्स्ड असेट का नेट इफेक्ट क्या है?
परचेज ऑफ असेट्स एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट,
परचेज आ रहा है, अच्छी तरह से देख,
सेल ऑफ असेट्स,
ओके, इट इज सेल ऑफ असेट्स, नो 542 वी आर गोइंग डाउन 450, तो ये परचेज होने से बढ़ता था या घटता था? घट रहा है ना, घट रहा है मीन्स
सेल
किया, कहाँ आएगा ये, वेयर इट विल कम,
नेट कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटीज,
ऑपरेटिंग में आएगा अच्छी तरह से,
कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम
सर इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी,
इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी में आएगा, ठीक है।
इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी
ऐड और लेस होगा,
ऐड
ऐड इनफ्लो ऑफ कैश, वेरी गुड। स्टॉक स्टॉक व्हाट टू बी डन, where you will consider stock as
opening stock and closing stock, opening balance and closing balance,
stock is a current asset, it will come changes in working capital, it is increasing, if current asset will increase what you will do, add or less?
Less.
But इसके reverse जाता है. Debtors.
Current assets.
Again, what will be the effect?
Increasing in current assets. Increasing less. Current asset. So, less.
Less, very good. Prepaid expense.
Current liability.
Satyanas, asset में liability कैसे दिख रहा है रे तेरे को?
सही सही, current asset.
क्या भी सीखा तुम लोगों ने? Prepaid expense as a current liability and outstanding salary will be current asset. कुछ भी बोलते हैं यार तुम लोग. So again, it is a current asset. What will be the effect? It is increasing. It will be deducted. Cash and all, you know, we will have to add less the opening cash. We will be getting the closing cash as our answer. Now let us do it. You have to help me. ये सारे चीज़ तो निकल जाएंगे. We'll be having our own value. What is the closing balance of profit and loss? $21,100. What is opening balance? 18,000. What is the net effect? Yes or no?
Yes,
sir.
Then we will take one by one. General reserve. Transfer to general reserve. How much? 9,000. Right?
Yes, sir. 9,000.
Okay, one more thing we have left. Interest paid. It will have two effects. एक तो यहाँ आएगा नॉन ट्रेडिंग नॉन रिकरिंग आइटम में, दूसरा फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी है. एडजस्टमेंट है ना, एडजस्टमेंट विल हैव टू इफेक्ट. सो दिस विल हैव टू इफेक्ट. इधर की तरह आएगा एक आएगा नॉन रिकरिंग आइटम एंड सेकेंड इफेक्ट फाइनेंशियल एक्टिविटी कैश इज गोइंग आउट. ठीक है, तो ट्रांसफर टू जनरल रिजर्व हाउ मच?
This
I did earlier. Proposed dividend of current year, proposed dividend of last year. Let us take this only. It will be better. Logical. So current year ka proposed dividend kitna hai? 1,04,400. This last year का proposed dividend we'll have to write in financing activity. अभी आप मत लिखो, but मैं लिख के रखता हूँ. Same logic I can apply for provision for tax also. Last year ka provision for tax we need to pay this year. Is saal mujhe pay karna hi padega. And current year ka provision we can take it as non recurring item, non trading item. So same way we will do. Last year ka provision is paid this year. 54,000. Income tax ne likha. Provision. आपको pay करना ही पड़ेगा government को. जैसे कैसे proposed dividend आपको pay करना ही पड़ेगा. Last year. कितना था 54,000 एंड करंट ईयर प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स विल कम हियर विच इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड इन वर्किंग कैपिटल Next, profit and loss we took, general reserve we took. Now these all are current liabilities. Interest on debenture भी ले लेते हैं. एक ही रह गया ना. This is an adjustment, so it will have two effects. $16,200. As well as we have paid, it will have subsequent effect here also. Again, it is an adjustment. We'll have second effect. Then what next we have? There are two current liabilities, creditors and overdraft. What is happening? Both are decreasing. If there is a decrease in current, current liability, what will be the effect? Kitna decrease ho raha hai creditors?
$18,000.
The decrease in creditors. Next, overdraft. How much it is decreasing? 225 minus 225,000 minus 122,400. 1,02,600. Am I right?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. 1,02,000.
Bank overdraft. It's decreasing by 1,02,600. Next. Anything else left out? No. Debenture will come in financial activity. We will take it up. Equity and this will also come in financial activity. We will take it up. Now let us come to the asset side and we'll go for current asset first. Stock. There is increase in stock, 90,000. Okay, increase in stock. What will happen? Will minus again. Hai na? Increase in stock. Correct hai?
Yes, sir.
Dusra hai. Debtors. There is again increase in debtors. 432 and 360. 432, 72,000.
Seven.
Last but not the least, prepaid expense, 9,000 to 5,400. $3,600. Okay. So we have taken the changes in working capital also. Now, what is the effect here in asset? There is sale of asset. How much? 90,000,
na? Yes, sir.
It will be added, sale of asset. Ek hi item hai. Direct le lenge. Acha, iska net effect to bata do. Iska kitna aaya value? Minus 72 plus 90 plus 3.6 plus 02 plus 286,200. 286,200. What is the net cash flow? 286,200 minus 205,200 minus 3,000 negative 77,900. So we have net operating cash flow negative, net investment cash flow positive. There was issue of capital. How much issue of capital we had? Issue of preference share capital, 90,000. to a 12% preference share capital. 12%. Issue of equity share capital. Equity share capital kitna hai? 90.
Yes, sir, 90.
This is also 90,000. One more item is there. The 15% debenture. How much? Batao mujhe. Of 15% debenture. Quickly. How much you are getting? 9,000.
Yes, sir.
Get me the net effect. 90 plus 90 plus 9 minus 16.2 minus 54 minus 90. 28,800. This is your net cash flow from financing activity. Get me the net effect. What I will do, 28,800 plus 90 minus 77, 40,900. What is the opening balance of cash?
21,600.
What is the closing balance of cash?
63,000.
टोटलिंग का कोई एरर है क्या? देखो कहीं 500 का कहीं हम लोगों ने एटलीस्ट, या तो फिर टोटलिंग में बैलेंस शीट में एरर रहे।